recruitment.
I mean, you would agree that the NPP refer to themselves as Danko Abuzia Dombo tradition. And so I'm sure that this message has been drummed home into the ears of Ghanaians. And to that extent, if the NPP is in power today, and it seems like honoring its hero, one of its heroes, I believe that it is within their own right, within the rights of their own party philosophies, ideologies, and traditions to do that. But secondly, we would also place this discourse within the broader context of nationalism, political party formation, and political party activities in the country within the 1940s, even going forward, and even bending back to the 1930s and the 1920s and all that. It's essential that we would agree that in as much as we want to discuss Dombo to belong to a certain political tradition that would have alliance with the UGCC, the UP tradition, largely that would be the case. We would also have to appreciate that those individuals, whether sang or unsung heroes, really made some contribution towards the development of our politics and the kind of engagements we had leading up to independence and also leading up to the building up of political party activities in Ghana. Having said that, I think that it's becoming too many that from time to time within this administration, under another Adu Gyamfi's government, we've seen a lot of naming, praising, hailing of UP tradition members. I pray and hope that Nkrumah and the other unsung heroes and heroines who played their role would be equally celebrated and praised and given credence as such. And I hope when such is done, Ghanaians would wholeheartedly embrace such naming and name changing and all the other related issues that are tied to them.